And we recovered from the CMA Awards. Anybody watch that?
Woo!
I think we are. Beyonce said hi to me. My husband insists it was him. We argued for about 5 minutes. And then Jay-Z walked by and he said hi. It was pretty cool. But Nashville was really on fire. It was
I thought it was a good show, didn't you?
Yeah.
Good show this year. They actually remembered some of the people that came out before 2000. It's funny because they've had amnesia with that for like a long time. I know the we're gonna do, speaking of people that went before you, I'm gonna talk a little bit about my roots. Is that okay? Can we do that? You know, I don't know, the older I get, or I should say the more mature I get, the more nostalgic I get. I guess that's sort of symptomatic of that. And I look back now and I just can't believe everything going on when I was growing up in Nashville, Tennessee, and what a magical place that was. If you think it's cool now, you should have been back then. Man, that was neat. All those guys in the sparkly suits and the ladies with the big har, H-A-R. Rhymes with car. You know what they say about that? The higher the hair, the closer to God. But the lady that gave my dad his first job in Nashville was a lady that I love very dearly. The world knew her, us kids knew her as Sarah Ophelia Cannon. And us kids in the world knew her as Minnie Pearl. She gave my dad, she was a class act. Believe it or not, she was trained as a Shakespearean actress. Yeah, she was, but she became a comedian and she understood how to talk to everyday people and she was a great communicator. Speaking of communication, she gave my dad a job. She featured him, and I'm gonna talk more about him. She featured him in her show. And there's another kid in the band by the name of Roger Miller. And Miss Minnie quickly caught on to the fact that Daddy wasn't talking during the song. Before the song, he wasn't talking after the song. He was letting Roger do all the talking. Daddy leaves stage, he said, Mel Tillis says thank you. And you know why, don't you? Because he had the speech impediment. And she caught him one day coming off stage, and I loved it because all 5 foot three of her stood up to all 6 foot four of him. She said, Melvin, what is this all about? She said, if you're gonna be an entertainer, you gotta learn to speak to the people. He said, I can't. She says, oh yes you can, Melvin. And she said, don't you worry about it. She said, they'll never laugh at you. They'll always laugh with you. And the world loves somebody who knows how to laugh at themselves. If it hadn't been for her, the Mel Tillis story and consequently the Pam Tillis story might have turned out a whole lot differently. This is my little personal tribute, and every time I sing it, I hope she's smiling down. Mama said, oh, Ophelia, are you dreaming tonight of a faraway stage with your name up in lights? She said, we'll be right back. Mama said, oh.